Farmer Ben Hamid bin Baharun is one of the few villagers from the seaside village of Kampung Tanduau along the coast of Sabah. He and his family fled their home after some 300 armed men intruded their village. The 47-year-old father of 12 recalls his experience when he encountered them.
Saya seorang daripada Kampung Tanduau. Lepas itu ada daripada seberang datang jam 2 setengah pagi. Lepas itu saya kan terkejut tidur. Dibangun oleh adik saudara saya. Dia bilang karena dia bilang ada orang. Dia bilang, aku bilang orang apa? Dia bilang Abu Sayyaf, dia kata. Jadi aku datang, enggak, bukan. Juga orang baik dia. Jadi lepas itu, jadi akulah duduk sampai pagi lah, enggak tidur. Karena aku risau. Jadi dia orang, saya cerita dengan dia orang. Aku tanya tentang apa maksud kamu ke sini. Dia kata kami ini dengan mendatang ini dengan ambil kasih. Cara apa damai. Oh, aku bilang begitu. Aku bilang kalau begitu baik juga. Lepas itu saya kira-kira jam pagi sudah kan. Jadi anak bini saya takut, terpaksa kami lari kelebihan. Asa tanah kami asa usul situlah. Jadi
berapa orang yang ada?
Yang saya nampak itu orang sana ada yang ramainya itu ada dua yang saya nampak pertama 50. Jadi lepas itu datang lagi ada tambahan lagi dorang. Kira dorang mungkin ada dalam 300 semualah.
He hopes that the problem will be resolved and their lives would return to normal as soon as possible. Meanwhile, the Malaysian security forces have blocked off all routes in the Felda Sahabat 17 oil palm plantations leading to the seaside village of Kampung Tanduau. However, some food supplies and water are being allowed in on humanitarian grounds as negotiations go on with the armed Filipino group. The group have made no attempts to break off the tight land and sea cordon area of around 20 square kilometers in the east coast of Sabah. At the entrance of Sahabat 17, General Operation Forces were busy patrolling the outer fringes of Kampung Tanduau, but they are sticking to orders not to move in. The Malaysian Maritime Enforcement Agency, Marine Police and Navy have cut off the sea entry from southern Philippines, whose close islands were Sipangkot and Sibutu, only 15 minutes away by speedboat. At the source of Tanjung Labian, about 50 kilometers away from Tanduau, police and navy units kept a close watch on fishing boats landing. Claiming to be the Royal Armed Forces of the Sulu Sultanate, they want to stay put in Sabah and not be deported to the Philippines.